Hey y'all, welcome back to mine and Catherine's channel. I hope you are all doing well. Today, as you can tell by the title, I'm going to be talking about my experience training for my very first half marathon. It's been a journey. I started at the end of October, I think October 27th to be exact. Not sure on the specifics, but it is my very first half marathon. I'm excited, nervous, and just really proud that I'm actually doing it and sticking with my training and actually following through with doing it. I was super surprised that I actually even signed up by the time like the sign up opened for the race I wanted to do. I was just amazed that I even had the courage to sign up, because I've said I wanted to do this for so long and just never have. You know, it's just something I always said I wanted to do, but in a week and 2 days, I'm actually going to be doing it, which is so wild. But I have my notes on my phone right here. I thought I would go through just a couple things that I wanted to talk about. First off, we'll talk about my history with running. It is non-existent. I don't have a history with running. I'm not a runner. I did not like to run. My brother is a runner. His girlfriend is a runner. I was just going to leave that to them. But some things happened in my life last fall that I needed an outlet, and I was like, you know what, I'm gonna run. I'm bored with weightlifting. I've always been into the gym and like always been very active, but never a runner. But I needed a new outlet and something else to focus on, so I said, I'm just gonna start running, and here I am. So that is how I got into it. But previously I did one day of cross-country training and I absolutely hated it when I was a freshman in high school and never looked back. So not a runner. I literally started from running half a mile. That was like the start of my training. So I've been training for like 8 months, which I understand is an extremely long amount of time. And my body is telling me that's an extreme amount of time to be training. I am so bored of running at the moment because I'm running so much right now that I just like can't. But we'll get into that later. But I started from running like half a mile, 3/4 of a mile, and now I'm up to 10, 11 miles. So like I really started from nothing. Like I said before, I went through some stuff last fall and I needed a new outlet. I needed something to focus on, something to clear my head, something to motivate me, something to look forward to. So I chose running as an outlet just because it was healthy. It was something that I wanted to do, and turns out I really enjoyed doing it once I got past like the big hurdles. Like hitting a mile was a big mark. I cried when I hit 3 miles, huge moment. I cried when I ran my first race, huge moment, which was like a 4 mile run. Like it was my warm up now, lol. But it was a huge moment, so that was really great. But like I said, I was just going through some stuff and needed a new outlet, which is why I started running. And then I was like, you know what, I'm gonna run a half marathon. So here we are. My running schedule consistently has been 3 days a week. Some weeks there's four, some weeks there's two, depending on like what my school schedule and work schedule is, and weather too. I started running on the treadmill when I was doing shorter runs, but then once I got up to 4 miles, I moved outside because running on a treadmill is really freaking boring. So had to do something, and I love running outside now. I can barely run a mile on the actual treadmill because I just like my mind wants to die. But so I usually generally run Monday, Wednesday, Friday. That was the majority of my schedule throughout the past eight months. But like I said, depending on my school schedule and work schedule and what all I needed to get done, and also like still being able to hang out with my friends and not feeling like my whole life revolved around my training. And all my friends have been really supportive within my training, so they understand like if I'm gonna be late to something because I have to run, or like can't go because I really need to get a run in, like they get it. So that's been nice. But generally it's 3 days a week, which has worked out really well for me. We did have a setback in January. I went to a reunion for a camp that I worked at this summer. If you don't know, I worked at a camp. I can make a whole video, multiple videos on working at camp. It's the best thing that's ever happened to me. But we had a reunion in January, and I was walking down a hill and I realized I had really bad pain in my knee, and I thought I just tweaked it during one of our football games that we had, but it still like continued to persist as I went back to school, and I like could not walk without crying. It's awful. So I went to the physical therapy department at my gym at school, and I spent about 5 weeks in physical therapy. My glute muscles had depleted, that's the word I'm looking for, and my quad was doing all the work, which caused friction on my IT band, which caused inflammation and pain within my knee, my patella. So, whole long story, but basically I just worked on glute activation exercises and building my strength back up, and then working back into running. I could still run because I didn't have pain when I ran, so I ran for 3 weeks while in therapy, and then I, towards the end, I took 2 weeks off to really let myself fully recover. And I would run at physical therapy in the anti-gravity treadmill, if you guys know what that is, so cool. So I would get to run there, but I wouldn't run on my own until I got the clearance from my physical therapist, which was awesome. So that was about 5 weeks. It didn't set me back too much, and it was really good to not be in pain anymore, so that was really great. I had a really great experience. It was really fun there. I loved it. But it did set me back a little bit in my training, but it's all good. I'm much better now. And now I know like what glute activation is, how to do it. I focus it a lot on my runs now too. If I notice that I'm being really quad dominant, I'll switch my running position, focus on doing hills to activate my glutes more. So it's been really eye-opening on how I'm running and how I can change my running to help my body. So that's been really, really great. I've loved that. My mood changes throughout this training. When I started, I was really, really hyped, like pumped all about it. And I was that way for a couple months. And then I hit physical therapy and I was just really kind of drained, and that was okay. But once I got the clearance for running, I was really, really excited because I missed it. Like, it was something I craved now during the day. It was a really great outlet. I felt really lazy when I didn't run, and like, it was wonderful. But then about the last 3 weeks of school, I would say it was really, really hard to motivate myself to go run because I've been training for 8 months. Like, I'm over it. I really want to get this race over with. I'm not even going to lie. Like, I'm at the point now, and it's not even that I don't like running. Like, I love it. Like, I enjoy it while I'm out and while I'm doing it, even when I'm in pain and it hurts and I can't breathe and, like, it's hot. I still really enjoy it, but it's mentally exhausting now because I spend so much time in my head on my long runs, and I'm just like, I need something else to think about. Like, I can't do this anymore. It's been better being home from school now because I have new routes to run, and I'm getting really close to the race, so like, I can really see the light at the end of the tunnel. It doesn't seem like I have so much more training to do. I only have a few more runs, I think three maybe, until my run, which is my race, which is so crazy. I'm really excited for my race. Like, I'm really excited to just say that I did it and like experience it and like just be in the race and actually running, and like, I'm just really excited for that moment to be like, I'm here, I'm doing it, I stuck with it. I don't have to run after this if I don't want to. I'm sure I will. I know I will. But it's just gonna be great to actually finish it. So I'm really excited about that. I got new headphones during my running, which are just wireless headphones. They're actually a lot here. I don't know what brand they are. They're from Amazon. I got them for Christmas. Sound Peats. These are great. I love them. They're really, really comfortable. I switch up my music for every run. I never listen to the same thing for every run. Like, I have a running playlist that I go to if I don't know what I want to listen to, but usually I have picked out my music way before my run because that's something I really enjoy because I love music. So it's really great to just chill out, kind of jam out on my run. I love it. I love my running shoes that I have. I have the Brooks Launch. I had the Launch 4 and now I have the Launch 5. I just started running with the Launch 5s and I'm getting used to them. They're a little bit different than the Launch 4s, but they're good. I love both of them. They're so comfortable to run in for me. Another thing that I've been loving about training is how much food I eat, because I eat so much because I'm running like 20 miles a week, so I run a lot and sweat a lot, and I'm always active and moving and walking around campus and doing all that, so I get to eat a lot of food, which has been so nice because I love to eat, so, and I don't really ever feel bad about it because I know I'm just going to run it off on a 9-mile run, so it's been great. Another thing I've really loved is like kind of people's reactions when I tell them that I'm training for a half marathon. They're like, how could you do that? Like, that's so much. Like, I would die. And like, I get it. I would have said the same thing 8 months ago. But once you start doing it and start running and start building your endurance, like, you're like, dang, I can do it. Like, I can really do it. It's really fun. And, like, my friends always, not make fun of, but kind of pick at me for, like, oh, how many miles are you running today? Like, what are you going for today? And asking about it, which has been really supportive and really fun and a great motivator for me, too, just to, like, be able to talk about it. And that was another thing when I said I was going to do it. I told everyone I knew that I was going to run a half marathon. That way they could hold me to it and say, how's your training coming? And I could actually tell them rather than saying, oh, I quit. You know, it was just a great accountability system, I guess, that I didn't want to let people down. I also didn't want to let myself down, but it's harder for me to let other people down than it is to let myself down. So that was a great way to keep me accountable. The last thing I want to talk about is how I feel a week out. I'm ready. Like, I just want to get it over with. Not over with, but I just wanted to be here. Like, I want to freaking do it. I want to do the thing. So, I'm really excited. My brother's running it with me, which is going to be great. He's going to finish, like, an hour, 20 minutes before I will because I'm slow. I am not going for speed. I'm going for actually finishing. I'll go for speed during my next races because I'm just trying to finish at this point, but I'm ready. My two best friends are going to go down with me, and we're running in North Carolina at the beach, so we're going to spend a few days at the beach before the race and then run on Saturday, and I'm excited for them to be there when I get done and just to hang out with them and, you know, get to run and actually do it. I'm pretty excited. My legs kind of hurt, but my legs are so, honestly, so exhausted. I'm ready to, like, take a good 2 weeks off and not feel guilty that I'm gonna not be ready in time or whatever. So, yeah, that is how my first half marathon training experience has gone. Hope you guys like this video. I will make a video once I finish it and let you guys know how my race actually went and how I felt during it. But this is just how I'm feeling now, how the past 8 months has been. For me, it's been wild, it's been an adventure, definitely something new, a new learning curve, but I've really enjoyed it, and I'm glad that I've picked up this, not skill, but like activity, I guess, that I'm excited to continue. So, yeah, I will see you all in my next video. Bye!